my parents would race catamarans together. Like, they would travel around the coast as a little team. And then they had me, and they transferred over to like a little cruising sailboat. And they would hang me from the handrails here in a little jolly jumper, and we'd go sail into the islands, and I suppose they would just like swing around as they'd sail the boat. And then my brother came along, and we got a trawler, something a little bigger, two bedrooms. But yeah, we spent our time on boats down here. Barbara's about an hour away from LA, but so far removed from LA at the same time. You know, just geographically, we have mountains that separate us from the valley inland, and then obviously we're on the coast, and 25 miles out to sea is the Channel Islands. In west, you got cattle farms and open land to Point Conception, so it's kind of this cool little pocket nestled, you know, in this little bite of California. There's a cool community here, and we kind of all go in the same patterns, you know. All my friends are interested in the same thing, so I've always found a way to stay like a little rooted here. Oh, baby. Yes, oh, baby. Yes, oh, baby. My dad got me into surfing. I was probably 7 when I got my first board. I got a little, what they call fun-shaped, like thruster, Yater egg. I was like 7 or 8 or something. And then in junior high, 13, 14, I was like, surfing's my thing. That's when I started doing contests. And they were fun. They were fun, like social things to travel around with my friends. My parents had a little camper, so we cruised up and down the coast. I never did that great in the contest. I just chugged through it. It was fun enough to travel with the friends, you know, surf different parts of California and meet different people. A couple of my friends started homeschooling, and then I didn't have that many friends going to Santa Barbara High for whatever reason. So I went to San Marcos for 1 year and just really didn't like it. Basically, I spent my whole freshman year talking my parents into letting me homeschool or do independent studies. They didn't really do anything aside from support me, and it was all self-taught with a remote teacher I'd go to once a week. And so I'd meet up with them, do tests, and get it done that way. But basically just surfed a lot and traveled, to, you know, kept doing the contests. And then when I was 17, I got sponsored and started meeting people at Patagonia. And then I started getting invited on trips and having a travel budget and a little salary. Started ditching class to travel to Fiji, you know, and whatever, Central America, Mexico was one of some of my first trips. I was with Patagonia for 7, 8 years, you know, and sort of moving up the ladder, becoming more serious and taking on bigger projects among Patagonia, doing films and, you know, certain things. When I moved out, we moved to this funky, cool little studio in Gobernador Canyon in Carpinteria. So we lived there for a year, and then we rented another little house like right at Rincon with a bunch of friends. But we were paying, you know, $1,500 to $2,000 a month for a room and a house. Don't make much money to begin with, and a lot of your money's going to rent, it felt like. At that time, I didn't have a boat. I just had this longing for the harbor like that I grew up in, and just wanted to be able to go to the islands or just go sailing or out in the water in general. So we just got a big enough boat to live on, and it's been 6 years. We're stoked on it. Photography just came from being surrounded by photographers on surf trips and them motivating me to pick up a little film camera and shoot stuff on the travels and stuff. You know, it's just enjoyable. It's like really pretty straightforward. You know, it's just like you bring this thing, you just kind of shoot along the way and you get some cool things out of it. The Tiny Mess was one of those projects where we'd be having dinner parties at our boat or our friend's camper, and we'd be making these insane meals, and I would just snap photos here and there, and it was just a fun, like, project idea to come, you know, just to document other people doing this sort of thing, living this sort of way. The dream plan is to get like a bigger catamaran, like 45 to 55 foot, totally self-sufficient water maker, solar panels, just totally dialed. And basically just start going somewhere, and that just leads you to somewhere else. Like, you know, you start going down Baja, then you end up Central America, Ecuador, you know, maybe you go to South America, or maybe you jut over to Tahiti or Marshall Islands, and then from there, I imagine you start pointing it direction in different ways. But that'd be the dream, just to kind of figure out a way to sail full time and still make films and do photography and surf, you know, surf everywhere. And yeah, hopefully someday soon. I think there's lots to be done traveling by boat.